Hello, hi, welcome back to my channel. Super excited to be doing this try on because it's all fun colors. Finally, we have a collection from Buff Bunny that is nice, bright, pastel colors. As usual, I will be starting off with my absolute favorite outfit of the whole collection, which is the Micro Legacy shorts in Lover Pink. Look at this pink. Paired with the Halter Seamless bra in Bubbles Blue. Look at that, completely open back. Yes, I did also get the matching bra. This is the Buttercup sports bra. Super cute, but she's a little restrictive on my lats, so I do prefer the Halter Seamless over this one. Starting off with the shorts. How cute are these? I feel like they're the perfect length. They're 6 inches. These shorts come in Afterglow Yellow, Lover Pink, Lavender Haze, and Onyx Black. They have a medium compression, but I honestly feel like they're more light compression. They're a little less high on your waist than the OG Legacy leggings and shorts. These would be better for people with shorter torsos. Like if you felt like the Legacy stuff was always a little bit too high on you, just too long, the Micro Legacy would be a better option. I've already worked out in them and they don't move around at all. They're so comfortable. They're so soft. They're the Nubra fabric, so they're just like silky second skin material. The waistband is not super compressive. They are very stretchy. I think that they're true to size. I think you should stick to your usual size.
Editing Silvs here. After wearing these a few times, taking them on and off, they have stretched out a lot. So I would actually recommend sizing down if you are in between sizes or if you prefer a more compressive fit. They now fit me like a medium, so you can definitely size down.
And they look super cute on the glutes. They have like that same contouring as the regular Legacy leggings and shorts. So I put the Buff Bunny sticker inside there. You can definitely see it. I would wear nude seamless underwear with these. Honestly, I think they're fine for leg days. I feel like it's just personal preference. I love how they look paired with the Halter Seamless sports bra. I feel like the Lover Pink and this blue just look so cute together. It's very like cotton candy. This is the back, nice and open back, perfect for a back day or any upper body day. So comfortable. I don't feel like it's too tight around here and here. A lot of the time halter bras just like cut into my neck and they're just really uncomfortable against my traps, but this is actually very comfy. I feel like it's because it's like that stretchy material.
Speaking of stretchy, after working out in this bra, I realized how much it stretches out. The straps stretch a lot. Like it's too stretchy. I really wish this bra held up better during a workout because it just stretches so much. You got to keep like pulling it up and it just doesn't sit as high as it is in these clips. There's like no support in this bra at all. I wore this to CrossFit. I wore this to calisthenics and in both it stretched out too much. So yeah, definitely for something very low intensity.
If you've tried the Alphalete Amplify sports bra, specifically these, they feel a lot like these. Honestly, almost exactly the same material. Even this like ruching here at the front is very similar. This one also comes with a strap that you can put in the middle, like on the back here, and it's adjustable too, so you can make it smaller. Honestly, it looks really cute. This is the first time I'm trying it with it on. So this bra does come in Lover Pink, in Afterglow Yellow, Cold Brew Black, Blue Bubbles, and Enchanted Teal. If you want the halter bra in any color, I would suggest getting on the website quick, like literally 1 p.m. CST or 2 p.m. CST if you're Toronto. Be on the website, okay? Be ready. I feel like the halter bras are gonna sell out at least in one color. I don't know if it's handstand approved yet. I haven't had the chance to test it out. I'm gonna test it out and I will let you guys know if I have any nip slips, if I can actually wear it for handstands. It does come with padding. I just take it out. So this is it without the padding. So I'm wearing a small here and I feel like it's true to size. You don't need to size up or down. It looks really small when you take it out of the package. Like I was like, oh my God, this is not gonna fit me. But as soon as I started putting it on, like it's really, really stretchy. These shorts with my pink bolero. I just love the pink and the blue. Okay, next bra I wanna talk about is the Buttercup sports bra. This one comes in Onyx Black, White, Cold Brew, and Lover Pink. This one is more light support. It's definitely for smaller boobs. I feel like there's less room for them in this one. It has like a ruching detail here at the front, and then the straps here are adjustable. It also has like a crisscross design there, and the little Buff Bunny logo. So it looks super cute paired with the Micro Legacy shorts, also in Lover Pink. If you like that color, this is a really nice set. The back isn't like too high coverage, but it does cut into me here. Like I find this part a little bit too tight, just where it like sits on my back. Just keep in mind if you have like bigger lats, a wider back, It does feel tighter on me in that area. The Halter Seamless is definitely more comfortable than this one. Also, the straps, like, this is the max I could adjust them to. I wish I could make them longer, like looser. This does feel very, very tight. If I could just adjust it a little bit more, that would be nice. So unfortunately, this one is not handstand approved. I did feel the nips kind of escaping a little bit after a few handstands. Like, it wasn't immediate, but it did eventually happen. So it's not 100% safe for that. But for like a regular workout, a bodybuilder style workout, like anything else that's not too high intensity, I'm not sure about this bra for CrossFit. I'm going to try it and see. It's very cute though, and it does come with padding. I have the padding out here. Can we just take in how cute this outfit looks with this tote? This is the game changer tote. I decided to try the little mini one because I work from home, so I felt like I didn't really need the big one. But if you needed like a new work bag or a more like fancy gym bag, there's a big version of this. I feel like this one is just perfect for going out or for like every day. It has a little pocket here at the front and then a zipper, so you can actually fully close the bag, which I love. I feel like sometimes these style bags don't like have anything there, or it's just like a button. And then it does have a zipper there on the inside, and it comes with a strap that you can like attach to the sides here, so you can make it longer, like more of a crossbody bag, and it also extends. Honestly, it's much bigger in there than I thought it would be. Vegan leather, it's very soft. It just feels really, really nice and high quality. I had someone message me on Instagram saying they were so happy these were back because they have the big one and they've had it for like 6-7 years. I feel like this is just a staple. That color is bone, but it also comes in onyx black, and the big one is actually big enough to fit like a 16-inch MacBook. The big one also has like a built-in padded part so you can put your laptop in there and it's like nice and protected. Okay, let's change colors. Let's move on to the Micro Legacy shorts in lavender haze. This purple is beautiful. I also have the Micro Legacy leggings to show you and the matching lavender haze sports bra. This one is the Candy Crew sports bra. Look how cute these two look together. Such a nice combo. Like, it's just purple is so nice. The legacy shorts feel the same as the pink ones. They're like a light compression. They're very comfy. Second skin feel. They have that three seam contouring. And then this bra. Oh my god, this bra is stunning. It's high coverage. It's supportive. I feel like it's just the perfect sports bra. Good for high intensity exercise. I love the ruched detailing here at the front. It has adjustable straps there at the back. If you want something that's high coverage, high support, this is the sports bra for you. Like, look how cute. Oh my god, I love the strappy back. I prefer this one to the candy wrap sports bra just because the candy wrap one, it sits a little bit too low on me. That one is coming out in all of these fun pastel colors too. So in case you're a big fan of the candy wrap bra, it's coming. It's coming in more colors. I personally would choose this one over that one. It's gonna be great for CrossFit. It's gonna be great for any high intensity exercise. So really highly recommend this bra if you're looking for something high support. Also, it's true to size. You don't need to size up. This is a size small. Okay, the next bra we have is very different from the previous one. A lot more minimal, less coverage. Definitely more meant for girls with smaller boobs. This one is the Twisted Sports Bra. It comes in Afterglow yellow, bone, and onyx black. I love that they included it in yellow because I can pair it with all of the other pastel bottoms. It looks so good with lover pink. Light to medium support. It's definitely more medium because of the fact that back is like this. So it does feel more supportive than you'd think. It has removable bust pads, but I did take them out here. So this is really, really cute. I would recommend this more for low intensity exercise. I don't know if I would jump around in this just because the girls, they're coming out the sides there. Like, it's very low coverage. Like, I did test this out with handstands and shockingly, my boobs did not just completely come out. It actually was okay, but I didn't want to keep testing it. I felt like after a few, there would be a little bit of nip. For a bodybuilder style workout, for a low intensity workout, I think this will be totally fine. If you prefer more high coverage, if you don't want the girls to be spilling out, I wouldn't go for this bra. Bra is also really restrictive on your back, especially if you have wide lats. Don't love how it feels here. I feel like I just can't move around as freely. Like, my back, it just isn't as comfy. And then the straps here are very short. Like the length from here to here isn't very long, so I do really feel it on my shoulders. And if you have wide shoulders, you have bigger traps, you're gonna feel the straps kind of like slowly moving down. They're just not long enough. I feel like if the straps were longer, then it would feel better in that area. But if they were longer, then I feel like it wouldn't be as supportive. And I really like how supportive this is. The yellow is stunning. If you can get your hands on anything in this afterglow yellow color, do it. It's really, really nice. I'm sad we don't have a matching pair of bottoms with it. It does look really good paired with like any of the other pastel bottoms. But yeah, if you have bigger boobs, I would not recommend this bra. Okay, next thing I want to show you is the micro legacy leggings. These are coming in lavender haze, onyx black, and enchanted teal. The inseam is 26 inches. They are full length leggings and they're medium compression. They're also high rise. They're not like ultra high rise like the original legacy leggings. If you have a shorter torso and you prefer when things aren't super, super high, this is a better option. Again, in the color lavender haze, super cute. They are true to size. I wouldn't size up or down. Same detailing at the back there as the short. Now it has like the arch there. You can see the Buff Bunny sticker through them. I would recommend nude seamless underwear. I'd recommend that with any of the light colors in this collection. You wanna just be wearing light colored underwear. I think these are fine for squatting, but we'll see. The waistband on these is just so nice and forgiving. Same as the shorts, just really, really comfortable. Okay, next leggings I wanna show you is the Candid cross waist leggings in Lover Pink. These leggings also come in cold brew and onyx black. The inseam is 26 inches, so they're full length. They're high rise and they're supposed to be very flattering on your glutes. Unfortunately, these are not my favorite. I feel like they need some improvements. Either that or they're just too small on me, maybe that's why. So they're very flattering on my waist. Like this cross waist is really cute. Like it's just this area here. I do get camel toe with these and it's not comfy. That's our anatomy. There's nothing wrong with seeing camel toe, but it's uncomfortable. So I think it's because of the way the back was designed. Because this like pulls up, it also pulls up at the front too. It's just, oh my God, it's not comfortable, which is just so disappointing because they are really cute. They are also extremely see-through. Look how much you could see the sticker there. Much thinner than the micro legacy legging. So disappointed because I was really, really looking forward to a nice pastel pink legging from Buff Bunny. I wish I would have gotten a size up. If you're in between sizes, I would definitely size up in these. If you size up, it might give that glute area more room and not pull as much. So I just wish I had sized up. I don't even need to do a squat test with these. Like you guys already know. It's just such a shame because I love this waistband. It's so nice. I always like the crossway stuff that Buff Bunny comes out with. Okay, last but not least, the only thing I got in a darker color is the contour pocket flares. I love Buff Bunny flares. When I saw these, I was so excited. To compare them to the Material Girl ribbed flares, those are my favorite Buff Bunny flare until these. Until these. These have three different length options. So there's short, regular, and tall. They look so good with my UGG platforms or just any platform shoes. They're medium compression and they are high rise. These are just so comfy. These feel like if the curve leggings and the Material Girl rib leggings had a baby. Like this is a combination of the two of them. Detail here at the front with that seam reminds me of the curve legging. And then of course the flared part reminds me of the Material Girl. These have a pocket on both sides and the V detail there at the back. They're very forgiving around your waist. They don't feel too compressive. You could literally wear these all day. So you can see them with a regular baby tee, not a sports bra. They meet the top of my t-shirt. This is exactly how I would use them for everyday wear. They're so comfortable. I'm telling you, if you need flares, get these Buff Bunny ones. These pocket flares are also true to size. You don't need to size up or down. I'm wearing a small and they fit perfect. Whereas with the Material Girl ribbed flares, these fit very, very tight. These are more compressive because of that like ribbed material. They're very compressive, so I would recommend sizing up in these. If I had to pick between the two, if you want a more comfy everyday wear legging, I would go with the contour pocket flare. The Material Girl rib flares are just like something different. They're a little bit more like fancy because of like the rib detailing. They just look like nicer. They're a good like going out legging or for work too. Like if you want something that isn't just like the basic spandexy look, the ribbed ones are really nice. They're very thick too. But for everyday wear, definitely the contour pocket one. Oh, and if you get that tote bag, it comes with this bag. And I've already been using this to put like my gym clothes after my workout. Like if you change after the gym and you have nowhere to put like your nice gym wear, you don't want it to get like ruined in your gym bag and it's also sweaty. I've been using this bag just to put that stuff. Don't get rid of this if you get that toe. I really like this for that. Anyway, that's it for my try on. I hope you found this helpful. Let me know if you have any questions. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. It's callmesilvs. If you want to see calisthenics, CrossFit, that hybrid training style. If you want to learn how to handstand, there's lots of handstand stuff over there. This is all launching on April 13th, so don't forget to set a reminder on your phone. Thank you so much for watching. Okay, bye.